In previous video, I explained one of the reference electrode, that is hydrogen electrode. Today, I am going to explain about the second reference electrode is saturated calomel electrodes. Simply write as saturated calomel electrode as CE, and this saturated calomel electrode is also called as mercury mercurous chloride electrode. And construction of saturated calomel electrode, a glass tube and bottom of the glass tube is filled with mercury. Mercury is filled with the at the bottom, and above of which we are taking a paste of mercury mercurous chloride. At the bottom we are taking the pure mercury, and above which we are taking a paste of mercury mercurous chloride, and the remaining portion of the tube is filled with either decinormal, that is 0.1 m, either normal, this is one normal, or saturated KCl solution we are filling. And a platinum wire dip into the mercury for making the electrical contact, and the side tube is used for the making the contact with the salt bridge. And this is about the saturated calomel electrode construction. And this saturated calomel electrode potential value is depending on the concentration of the KCl solution we are taking. I am writing the reaction potential values of the saturated calomel electrode at different concentrations. For example, the KCl solution, the concentration of KCl solution and the reduction potentials at 25 degree centigrade I am writing. If you are taking the KCl solution as a decinormal, this is 0.1 n normal solution we are taking, the reduction potential value is 0.333 h. And if you are taking the one normal KCl solution, the value is 0.2800. If you are taking the saturated KCl solution, value is 0.2422. The reduction potential value of saturated calomel electrode depends on the concentration of the KCl solution. If you are using the decinormal KCl solution, reduction potential, the type of reference saturated calomel electrode is called as a decinormal saturated calomel electrode. If you are filling this tube with the one normal KCl solution, that calomel electrode is called as a normal calomel electrode. If you are filling the tube with the saturated KCl solution, that calomel electrode is called as a saturated calomel electrode. And this saturated calomel electrode is always work as a reduction offset. for the reduction process. And this saturated calomel electrode, this reference electrode, is used for determining the pH of the unknown solutions. With this, by using of this saturated calomel electrode, we can find the pH of unknown concentration solution. For this, I'm taking a hydrogen electrode. Already yesterday we have discussed the hydrogen electrode, and this is now this reference electrode is attached to the another hydrogen electrode of unknown concentration. There is hydrogen electrode. Already I discussed the platinum foil. Filled with the what? And here the platinum foil, hydrogen gas, we are passing at 1 atmospheric pressure, and here this is platinum foil. And here we are taking the HCl solution of unknown concentration. HCl solution of unknown concentration. Already yesterday we discussed about standard hydrogen electrode. What is standard hydrogen electrode? Either we are taking the 1M HCl solution. If we are taking the 1M HCl solution, that is a standard hydrogen electrode. But here what we are taking the unknown HCl concentration. The concentration of HCl we don't know. That is what? Unknown concentration. That is what? By using of this, now by using this saturated calomel electrode as a reference, we are finding the concentration of this H plus ion HCl solution. Okay, for this is making the contact, the potentiometer, and this is what I have told. This is used as for the making the electrical contact, making the contact with the salt bridge. Solved the side tube. With this, a total cell construction is formed. A total cell is constructed. This is a off cell and this is a off cell. The saturated calomel electrode, this reference electrode, is cathodic off cell. And now, this is hydrogen electrode of unknown concentration is anodic off cell. Now, this hydrogen electrode is working as an anode and this is a cathode. This is about a total cell reaction. And already yesterday we have discussed in the previous video how to represent the total cell reaction. And this is acting as anode. Anode means what? We are writing on the left side. Left side means what? This is the first writing the anodic off cell. First we are writing the what? Metal of this the H2 gas, that is this, with this metal ion. Metal ion is what? H plus of unknown concentration. Platinum H2H. This is anodic off cell. And these two are separated by the what? Salt bridge. Two vertical line indicates salt bridge. This is anodic off cell written. Then cathodic off cell is saturated calomel electrode. The saturated calomel electrode is first cathodic off cell written by writing the first metal ion, then metal. What is the solution we are taking? KCl. KCl of saturated KCl Hg2 Cl2 with mercury Hg platinum. This is a total cell representation. This is an anodic off cell representation. This is a cathodic off cell representation. Okay, once we are connected these two off cells with a potentiometer, some potential value will be how to find the EMF of the cell. Already know what is the formula for the EMF. E cell EMF is equal to potential of cathode plus potential of anode. Now What is cathode here? Cathode is about saturated gallium electrode. The saturated gallium electrode potential value is saturated 2.2422. Already just now I have given it. Because what? Anode. Yesterday, this is anode. Yesterday we have obtained two formulas. When hydrogen electrode acting as an anode, what is that? We got E is equal to 0.0592 of pH. When hydrogen electrode is acting as a anode, we get the positive. When it is acting as a cathode, we got what? Minus 0.0592 pH. Okay, that is what? Anode potential value. This hydrogen electrode acting as an anode now, that's why already this derivation already given in a previous class. So it is 0.0592 pH. This is E cell. From this, I am writing 0.0592 pH is equal to E cell minus 0.2422. From this, pH is equal to E cell minus 0.2422 by 0.0592. And in this pH, what is this E cell? E cell value is what? Potentiometer value. Once we are connecting these two offsets, in potentiometer some reading will be shown. That reading is value E cell, that is a known value. And this is a constant, this is a constant. By calculating these three values, we get the sum pH value. Once we know the pH, what is pH? pH is a negative logarithm of expression and concentration. Once we know the pH from this, by using anti-log values, we can find the expressed ion concentration. With this, find the concentration of unknown solution. Let us discuss about the queen hydrogen electrode. Now, construction of queen hydrogen electrode. In a beaker, we are taking HCl solution. Of unknown concentration, and it is this unknown concentration HCl solution is saturated with queen hydrogen powder, and we are adding saturated with queen hydrogen powder. And a platinum wire is immersed for making the electrical contact. This is the queen hydrogen electrode. And this quinone, this queen hydrogen electrode is for quinone and hydroquinone. Quinone the structure of quinone simply we are abbreviated as Q. This quinone and hydroquinone forms a reversible redox reaction in the presence of acid medium. The presence of acid medium is 2H+, presence of 2 electrons forms a redox reaction, that is forming OH. This is hydroquinone.
zero.
Phenhydrone is a phenone in the presence of acid medium producing hydroquinone. This type of redox reaction is possible, and this is simply abbreviated as H2Q. This is phenone, we are abbreviated as Q, H2Q. This is in the presence of 2H plus and 2 electrons producing hydroquinone. This is I am writing as a H2Q, phenone, hydroquinone. And the reduction potential of this is the reduction reaction. For this reaction is the gaining of electrons. This is a forward reaction, is a redox reaction, reduction reaction. For this I am calculating the potential value for this reduction reaction. The single electrode potential, the quinhydrone electrode potential value is calculated by using same what is an energy equation. What is that? EQ. EQ means quinhydrone electrode potential value is equal to E naught Q. E naught Q, the standard quinhydrone potential value, minus 2.303 RT. Otherwise, I am writing H 25 degree centigrade directly. The 25 degree centigrade energy equation is 0.0592 by N log concentration of products by concentration of reactants. Now in this reaction, this is a product. What is product here? What? Hydroquinone H2Q product. Then go to reactants. What are the reactants? Phenone, one is phenone, and we have the acid medium, that is what? H plus. But here what? We have the 2H plus. I am writing at the square, the corner. Now E naught Q minus 0.0592 by N. N is what? Number of electrons. How many? 2. Log. Here, the phenone and hydroquinone are we are taking in equimolar concentration. The phenone and hydroquinone are taking in equimolar concentration. That is, concentration of H2Q is equal to concentration of Q, and we are taking in equimolar concentration, phenone and hydroquinone. With this, these two will be get cancelled. With this log 1 by H plus square. Now here, the standard potential value of quinhydrone electrode is 0.6994. The standard potential value of quinhydrone electrode 0.6994, that is minus 0.0592 here by 2. Here I am writing this is a log, taking into numerator with this H plus of minus 2. The next here, I am writing here now, EQ is equal to 0.6994 minus 0.0592 by 2. If we take into starting, this is what? Minus 2 of log H plus ion concentration. By cancelling of these two, EQ is equal to 0.6994 minus 0.0592. I have minus log H plus, nothing but pH. EQ is equal to, this is this quinhydrone electrode, the reduction potential equation. Then next, by using of this quinhydrone electrode, we can find the pH of unknown concentration solution. The same way, last we should discuss it, how to find the pH of unknown solution by combining this there is a saturated this quinhydrone electrode without another hydrogen electrode of unknown concentration. Otherwise, we are taking the saturated calomel electrode as a reference electrode. And what is here? This pinhydrogen electrode is working as a indicator electrode. What is mean of indicator electrode? Indicator electrode is nothing but the potential of the indicator electrode will be changes with the changing the concentration. But reference electrode means the concentration of the potential of the reference electrodes will not changes with the changing the concentration. And this saturated calomel electrode, and by using of this pinhydrogen electrode, we are finding the pH of unknown solution. For this pinhydrogen electrode, of unknown concentration solution, this is pinhydrogen powder, pinhydrogen is saturated with pinhydrogen, and this is a platinum foil, and this is connected with the one of the reference electrode. There is a saturated calomel electrode. Already that, what is saturated calomel electrode construction? This is side tube, and this is platinum wire. Is a mercury above which a paste of mercury, mercurous chloride. The remaining portion is filled with what? Saturated KCl solution. Now this is what? This is a potentiometer. It is total. This is the off cell, and this is another off cell. Total cell is constructed. This is what? Pinhydrogen electrode, and this is reference electrode, saturated calomel electrode. This is the indicator electrode. And here concentration we don't know. We are finding the concentration of this unknown solution by linking with the reference electrode, that is saturated calomel electrode. Now this is a total cell, and this cell will be represented. This is the anodic off cell, and this is a cathodic off cell. And here what? Once we are attached this one, the total E cell is equal to, I am writing the formula of reduction potential of quinhydrogen electrode minus, I am writing this is second formula I am using for the EMF. Another word, reduction potential of saturated calomel electrode. And here reduction potential of quinhydrogen electrode, just now we have determined quinhydrogen electrode reduction potential value is 0.6994 minus the reduction potential value of saturated calomel electrode. The reduction potential value of saturated calomel electrode is, this is minus 0.0592 pH minus values. Reduction potential of saturated calomel electrode is 0.2422. Now this is E cell. I am taking to this pH turn to this side. 0.0592 pH is equal to the what? 0.6994 minus 0.2422 minus E cell. The E cell taking to right side with this. By doing of these two, point this pH is equal to 0.6994 minus 0.2422 minus E cell divided by 0.0592. By calculating these two, we get the 0.4597. Approximately, that is what minus of E cell by 0.0592. With this, once we know the pH of the, this is what, these are all our constant values, this E cell value is what, it's a potentiometer value, and once we get the potential, the potentiometer value, we find the pH. Once we know the pH, we can find the concentration of unknown solution.